we love. And on this day on SportsCenter, earlier we showed you the great Kerry Wood, 20 years old at the time, May 6, 1998, strikes out 20 Houston Astros to tie the all-time single-game record for strikeouts. Here was Kerry following that performance.
You know, I just try to go out and get outs and get a win. I'm more thrilled that we won the game today. You know, it was a close one, and we pulled it out. The strikeouts today were mainly on sliders. I threw the curveballs earlier in the count and to lefties, and you know, I was getting all three pitches over, and occasionally I threw a few changeups and got those over. So it was just one of those days where everything you throw is you know, crossing the plate.
What a fun day that was. We're now pleased to welcome in Kerry Wood 22 years later. At the time, Kerry, 20 years old, just your fifth career major league start. What do you remember the most about that 20 strikeout performance?
Well, it seems like a lifetime ago, honestly. You know, I remember obviously the weather. It was a kind of a overcast, rainy, cold day, which probably benefited me a little bit. And just remember getting to the yard and realizing that I was pitching that day and just didn't feel great. Energy level was kind of low. And really remember my warm-up session in the bullpen was terrible. You know, really just shut it down a little bit early and flipped the ball to Phil Regan, the pitching coach, and said, man, it can't get any worse than this. And then went and sat in the dugout and waited for the anthem to be over and walked out to the mound and started going.
So not only did you have a historic performance after a bad warm-up, you nearly had a no-hitter with the only hit by Ricky Gutierrez going off the glove of third baseman Kevin Ori. What was your take on that being ruled a hit instead of an error?
Well, when it happened immediately, I was upset at myself. I think it was the only hanging breaking ball I threw the whole day, and it was just a bad dumb pitch. And it never crossed my mind that Ori should have had that ball. And, you know, I just thought it was a hit. Now I've got a base runner on, and now I'm going to pitch out of the stretch, which, you know, for me at that time was difficult for me pitching out of the stretch. I was way more comfortable in the windup, so it really never crossed my mind that was a hit. And even looking at it now, I mean, even if he lays out for that ball and gets it, you know, Gutierrez had speed back then, so I don't think he gets him.
Even with the benefit of history to look back on it, you still maintain the same. And Kerry, those teams in the late 90s and the 2000s, a lot of postseason heartbreak for the Cubs, including the infamous 2003 Game 6 against the Marlins. Steve Bartman interfered with Moises Alou late in the game. What was it like for you, as we move on from that, to finally see the Cubs win the World Series in 2016?
Well, I mean, I think it was just being there and being at most of those games, it was thrilling as an ex-player and as someone that had gone through the ups and downs of being a Cub. And I was there with Ryan Dempster and Ryan Sandberg and you know, these guys are all watching this, and we lived it. We lived what it was like to be a Cub, and some of us were in the lovable loser years, and some of us were in years where we were supposed to do better and win and had a potential to pull the trophy home. And you know, just to be able to be there, I thought of all the players before me, the Ernie Banks, the Ron Santos, the Billy Williams, and Ferguson Jenkins, and the guys that tried it before my generation did. And to see it come full circle and finally see us pull it off for the fans of Chicago and the city of Chicago was pretty special to be able to be there and witness it.
You often hear players say, once a Cub, always a Cub, and certainly that's the case for you. Kerry, really interesting moment here in baseball. Start of the baseball season delayed due to the coronavirus pandemic. What do you think of MLB's possible plan to have three 10-team divisions based on geography, only playing opponents within their division?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, we're dealing with what we're dealing with. It's going to be interesting to see how that works out. I know that, you know, America needs sports and baseball in general. We all want to see the players back on the field. And ultimately, it's got to be whatever the safest is for the players, for the fans, and for the people that are attending these games or not attending these games. So I think they're doing the best they can with the situation that's thrown at them. I do know that Korean baseball right now is not enough for me and most people. As fun as it is to watch the bat flips, it's probably just not enough for us. But I think we'll do it right, and it's going to be one of those seasons that we look back in history and say this was, you know, this was kind of like when the season shut down in 9/11 for a week or so, and then you know, the strike of 94 when you look back and you see when baseball actually stopped for a while. Obviously, this is an extended stoppage of the sport and in all sports, so it's uncharted territory. So I think we're all looking forward to getting any kind of baseball we can and any kind of sports that we can, whether we get to go and watch it in person or at least we get to watch it on TV. And kind of, it just seems like baseball obviously should be played during the summertime, and it'd be weird to be out in summertime and not have a game on TV.
Hear, hear. Love hearing that from you, Kerry Wood, retired from the majors in 2012. on this day, May 6th, 1998, struck out 20 Houston Astros. Hey, Kerry, we really appreciate you making some time for us on SportsCenter and catching us up with what you're doing.